suggestion. What do you feel of, because you all are from the book line. No? See, we are not from the book world. We are not, I'm not from the, what do you say?
Natively you're not from it.
Reading, I'm not from that line. I'm from a different line. So when a person like you gives a message, we are going to put more cupboards, we're able to increase the concept. Somebody will want to know, Baba, what this fellow is talking, does he know? Okay, with that fellow is talking. So he said something.
Right.
Okay, one second. Huh?
So you ask me the question and then I'll answer.
No.
Okay, so the question is, what is your vision for the
way? Yeah. You can look at it. One second.
So,
one second. Huh? They're going to. Okay. Rico, you can ask the question.
What is your vision?
You know, this could become a very interesting way of promoting the reading habit at the grassroots level. It'll be a hard slog, but I think it could be very effective at the grassroots level. And though the reading habit is under threat, I think breaking the access barrier and making access easy is probably something which will help promote the habit. And then it kind of feeds on itself. People will read books, they will like it, some will come back, many will come back to the reading habit. They may have had that reading habit in school or in college, they'll come back to the reading habit. Others may have started and have had it on their New Year's resolutions to read more, and you know, it will come back. So I think it will help.
You need to give your name and you need to identify, you need to speak about yourself for 2 minutes.
My name is Oscar Braganza, and I've been in the corporate world all my life, and I retired from the corporate world in 2012, and I am now a leadership coach, and I work with CEOs and CXOs, coaching them on a one-on-one basis. I'm also a trustee with Bookworm, which is an NGO in the library and library learning space based out of Goa.
Mr. Braganza, what are the risks for a venture like this? I'm just having a naughty thought and thinking that, what if some scrap collector, ruddy collector comes and takes your full supply away, then what?
Well, that's a risk you've got to live with. And I would factor in
I don't think it happens. I'm exaggerating.
I think I wouldn't rule it out. But I think one has to live with the fact that there is some degree of risk. There is some proportion of books which will go away. But I believe that there will be enough people willing to donate books at a nuclear level in the individual areas that you put it. And that will probably and hopefully balance the outflow. And then some, you know, knowledge-based input to customize and tailor the offering of books in each outlet would add to that, would help.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
See, when we add a page to a project,
right,
it extends the project.